Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Far Cry 3. Before we meet up with Sam, we are going to take a little detour here to an old rundown bunker. Now, I showed off the Letters of the Lost earlier, and once you reach a certain point, you do unlock a signature weapon that's actually very good. We unlock the Tanto. You know, this is actually the very first and last melee weapon that you can ever unlock, and it actually adds a new section to the store. Here we have the Japanese Tanto that we can select instead of our machete. It basically just increases the damage of our slashes by a little bit. It's not really all that useful at this point. It can be kind of decent against heavies if you can't assassinate them.
Tools of the trade? Party favors. I've been waiting to light this place up, as we Americans say, for a very long time.
Sam, you're American?
Yeah. My father was in the Navy SEALs. I was born when he was stationed in Texas, and then he was relocated back to Deutschland.
Oh, Uncle Sam. I get it.
Yeah. One of the founding fathers, I think.
You might want to look that up.
Forget it. Let's put some candles on this cake.
Drive to the oil reservoirs. I'll cover with the 50 cal.
So, Sam, do you think maybe we should be wearing masks while we do this?
Blitzkrieg!
I mean, people don't really recognize me, but everyone at the base seems to recognize Sam. That would be a good idea. Oh, I think Sam will be fine. We'll just have to leave him here and plant some explosives. Or he could have 60% of his health taken away in one shot. Yes. From this point on, the game will get kind of annoying with its one shots. Not just against you, but even against Sam. Which is very disappointing because I kind of, I don't know, look up to Sam as a role model of sorts. Kind of odd that he should be able to die, really.
Finally, after all these years, I get to take them to the cleaners. Go! Take out the second reservoir!
So when you're driving through this area, and you have to leave Sam somewhere, you don't necessarily should rush in to plant the explosives. You do kind of have to empty out the area for him to help him out a little bit, or try to park him in a strategic location where he can't complain. But that's easier said than done sometimes in this area. Unfortunately, my timing here was a little off, so I wasn't able to just get the runaround takedown on these guys. But, as you can see, the Tanto does make short work of them, even if you don't assassinate them. I think it's about 4 slashes to kill a heavy. So I believe it does count as, I think, half a slash extra over the machete. And sorry for that awful jump cut there. We only went 5 feet down the road. I'm not really sure why the time of day changed between loading screens, but just know that I kind of had to do it because this area also had that guy. And the rockets, they usually make them miss on the first shot so that you have an idea of where they are, or that you at least know that they threw in a guy with a rocket launcher who can one-shot you. But on that occasion, he just hopped around a corner and hit a square in the car. And this, you might notice, is not the same exact sniper rifle we had before. It's got different camo and does not have the silencer. This is the AMR rifle. It's the most expensive signature weapon in the entire game. And good reason, really. It is upgraded to have a higher capacity magazine. And is a fires high explosive rounds. Which makes it really the strongest weapon in the entire game. So it costs nearly $5,000.
Panzer machine gun! I am going in!
Of course, it just wouldn't be a SAM mission if we didn't man a machine gun. Mystically, once SAM decides to leave the car, RPGs only do so much less damage to it. And I can't fault them too much for the amount of damage that Sam takes. It is annoying how random it seems to be, where he can just be chucked down bit by bit and then suddenly lose over half his health to one bullet. But they do at least make it to where when you're in the car with him, his health regenerates very, very fast.
Poker game! Don't leave me hanging! Meet me back at Hoyt's compound.
I think we should maybe tell Sam that his AK is haunted. I don't know. Something tells me he really would not mind. Now we're gonna head on over to the compound, and, well, if all goes well, kill Hoyt. And we'll have to decide if we really want to stay here or not.
Okay, my friend. Are you ready to do this? Or do you need more time? Because once we start this, there's no going back.
And this is basically just a message to tell you that, hey, this is going to be the end of the game. Finish up any side quests you want, or move on.
I have hidden a knife in my boot. Be ready to distract him when I say deal.
Okay, got it.
Ah! Welcome, boys! Come in, come in! Take a seat! Five card, hold them all right with you? Yeah? Can I offer you anything? Would you like some food? A nut, perhaps?
No.
What a job. Poker. Ask anyone on the street and they'll call it a game of chance. Or talk to Sam here and he'll say it's about bluffing. Weren't you, Sam?
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's not, is it? About keeping you playing until the house collects? Well, there's more where that came from.
I really wanted that nut, Jason. Seems like a good hand. Let's like any this. True poker player, we all in on the very first go.
I'll raise. I'll call.
A little unfair, they got to start with more money than we did.
Check. Check.
Although we all seem to have the same amount of chips.
I check. I check. Sorry. House rules. Ah, look at that. We have the same cards. So let's raise the stakes a little, shall we? Foster, Jason Brody, whatever your name is, slipped my mind. How stupid do you think I am? We should keep playing. Dealers on the left, right? Guess he's sitting this one out. So, got your little reunion with Riley. Brought a tear to my eye. Rarely moved. I'll admit, I underestimated you. Torturing your own brother. Destroying half my organization.
Anybody notice he flipped the burn card?
But let the chips fall where they may, right? I forgive you. So, name your price. Everybody has one. You're all puppets, and we pull the strings. The system was designed to work that way.
Screw your system.
We have to bet our life. I guess we shouldn't have gone all in on the first go.
You know what, Jason? I'm going to go easy on you, since you're a family man. One finger every time you lose. I'll start with the ring finger.
we'll never be married. You know, you could have joined me. Every kill would have been rewarded with money.
Fuck you.
I take no pleasure in this. Really, I don't.
I don't need 10 fingers to use a knife.
I've been doing this long before you were born, kid.
Bring it on, old man.
A knife that you have never used before in this game. I guess I got it from Sam.
I'm very disappointed in you, Jason. You haven't checked up on your little brother, Riley.
Where is he?
Don't worry. I sold him to someone very special. Him and he likes them young.
I'm gonna kill you.
I have very powerful friends who will hunt you down.
They won't find anything left of you.
You can't win. I hold all the cards.
Then why are you afraid?
Your brother's at the airstrip. I don't want to miss that plane.
I'll delay the flight.
That was one hell of a knife fight. So it seems as though there is not a single character that I like in this game that can actually stay alive till the end. I guess Dr. Earnhardt is now my new number one favorite living character in the game. I don't think he's really significant enough to be killed off, so I think we're... So it was kinda nice that, Hoyt actually just told us where our brothers were.
Close the gate! Secure the torpedo!
And you know, with how... Hoyt said that we could have joined him. I don't think he really gave us an opportunity for the fact, you know, he was kind of putting the price of an entire private island on our heads. And you might be hearing these explosions going off. Yeah, there are semi-random explosions that go off in this area. You get hit by one shot kill.
Hello?
Jason, where are you? They're taking us. I don't know where. We need your help.
What? I can't hear you.
Kill as fast as you can.
What the fuck? Airstrip's nearby. Be there, Riley.
The ever clingy girlfriend.
Shit! I don't need this right now.
Well, did anybody really expect the car to make it all the way there? Helicopter might be a little bit of an issue, or it would if we didn't have a sniper rifle that shot explosive rounds. So yeah, I guess the whole wearing masks thing when we were taking out half of his operations, which is apparently just two bases. One base and one gigantic satellite dish.
Where's Riley Brody? Where is he?
Great question. I'm sure someone will answer you in a timely fashion, Jason. Anyway, I guess we maybe should have worn masks when we were, you know, riding through his face and blowing everything up and killing everyone. Fortunately, the fire has some issue going with the chain link fence, but bullets don't.
Oh, thank God!
I made it.
Oh, thank God! I didn't know if you were gonna come.
We have to get out of here.
Okay,
follow me.
I thought I'd never see you again.
You haven't really been able to tell that these things shoot explosive rounds until just now, when people's bodies go flying 10 feet back when they get hit. I don't really think that any other signature weapon is broken.
Can you fly a chopper?
No!
You have your pilot license!
Yeah, I got that for a plane!
Well, now's the time to learn!
What? Oh, shit!
Holy crap!
Come on, Riley, you're a Brody. You instinctively have great knowledge of many things that are way beyond your comprehension. Ironic that Hoyt used this song to celebrate blowing up a ship of people he held captive, and now it's playing when we're tearing apart the remnants of his private army.
I think I'm getting the hang of it. Are you okay?
Yeah, awesome.
It's good to know that even after the whole "What have I become?" stint that Jason had, he's still a party boy at heart who laughs and has a great time when he's gunning down troops of people.
Guys on the bridge!
Taken care of, Riley. This part of the game is actually fairly easy. Surprisingly.
You are insane!
As long as you don't forget about the helicopter, or forget about the RPGs, you should be able to come through this area pretty much unscathed. I've heard it's much worse on the actual difficulty, but I don't know. This isn't too far off from max. Only one difficulty. I'm glad, though, that they added this part in, because I don't have nearly enough copyright strikes on my account as it is. Now, all this damage I'm dealing with these helicopters is actually unable to apply until they start shooting. Once they started shooting, they kind of just detected that they should be dead. Oh. Which is tumbled out of the sky. On the weekend, just instinctively knew how to pilot a helicopter.
Wait here!
No. Come on.
What happened?
Don't tell me.
Shit.
Son of a bitch!
Where are my friends?
I couldn't halt the jungle warriors. I'm sorry. They carried your friends to the temple.
So passes another tragic character.
I need to get to the temple.
And my last favorite character alive, which means
Riley, we have to go now.
I'm basically it is Jason now. Just no characters left at this point. Win by default, Jason.
Where the hell is everyone? Sitcher, what have you done with my friends?
I'm glad you returned victorious.
Hey!
Where are you taking him?
I'm helping you. Look at you. Big, strong, powerful. Why would you want to go back to what you were? You leave with all these burdens. The path purified you, but the cleansing is not complete.
What do you mean?
Love you, Jason. But you do not let me give you all my love. I know how hard this must be. It hurts me to watch you in pain.
Citra.
I only want to help you. Love you for who you are. To worship the man you have become. It will all be over soon. I will lead you onto the dais, and you will be free of your past. And then, I'll be yours. Walk the path of the warrior. Only the strongest survive. With the Rakia, you are powerful. Like those who came before you.
Knives taken. We will bring them back.
Lisa?
The warrior you are! I know you shot Falk in the back!
No!
powerful warrior. You deserve the final Tatao. They will all fall at your feet.
Look. You're carrying all these weapons, and you have all these weird tattoos.
You think you're a warrior because you collected those tattoos on your arm? I'm deleting them, Jason!
You're a hero. Your friends, they will move on. Have kids and boring lives.
Is this really even a decision?
The jungle
you joined Citra
be
after what she did to Earnhardt, then you were just the worst kind of person.
With them gone, you never have to leave.
This violence is over. I'm done. No more blood.
Jason. Look at me. Stay with me! You don't need any of them! You are powerful on your own! Jason, I love you!
Jason! What is wrong with you? She tried to save me! She saved all of us! And you reject her love? Ah!
I love you. Don't leave me.
I'm sorry. Citra, please. Do not leave me, please. Citra, I am sorry. Citra, please don't leave me.
So many people, I've lost count. I can't come back from this. I'm a monster. I can feel the anger inside me. But I am still somewhere inside me more than that. Better than that.
And so ends the story of Jason Brody. At least he went out in true asshole fashion from start to finish. We all know he could have dodged that knife lunge from Dennis. Especially after watching that knife fight against Hoyt. That would have been no problem. But nope, he just has to throw Citra in front of him. And let Dennis take her out, take out the love of his life, leave him a groveling mess on the floor. Kind of surprised that the Rakiat actually let them leave after that, but... well, I don't know, I guess maybe leadership just defaulted to Jason after that point and he just left? I don't know. I will be showing off the other ending that you get if you side with Citra, but that's going to be in a bonus video. So yeah, that's Far Cry 3. I really do love this game. I love the characters in it. The setting is good. Gameplay is a lot of fun with all the different weapons and all of that. Even though you are controlling a total douche, and most of your friends are forgettable, the characters like Voss, Sam, even Dr. Earnhardt with as small of a role as he had, are all very good, very well done. Even though they... none of them really get a whole lot of screen time, unfortunately. I kind of wish that they had put as much depth into Jason's character as they had put into somebody like Voss or Sam, or even Dr. Earnhardt with the little backstory about his daughter. But they wanted to go with the story of... kind of with a theme of developing as... kind of like developing into a killer and seeing how it changes you. And, you know, we've heard extensively from the CIA agent. I believe his name is Harper. Earlier on, about how everything in the jungle changes you little by little. And you can't even really tell. And that is why he stayed inside of his hut with the American flag and all that, because it represented order. And I honestly don't really think that Jason even showed any change up until the point where he was forced to torture his brother. And that was nearly the very end of the game. And then even then, in the helicopter scene, he's just like, yeah, woohoo! Come on! And just gunning down troves of people like it's nothing and enjoying himself. And then at the very end, talking about how he's killed so many people that he's lost count and he'll never be the same again and he's a monster and all that. You really just don't get the sense that he even really believes that, and they just had to throw in some angst for him. So I think of all the combined flaws in this game, I'd say that Jason's character is really the biggest. Now, they did have the whole thing with Voss right before we killed him, when it was kind of trying to insinuate that you and Voss were the same person. And, you know, that could be there to represent, you know, that if you followed the path of Citra and just became a warrior and tried to keep your civilized self in check, you know, without your friends there to help you or anything, then you could end up like Voss. And Voss is kind of the product of an uncontrolled environment where he's just, you know, hungry for power and brought up in an environment of violence and all that, and embraces it. Whereas you kind of get the sense that Jason is following the path of rejecting the violence and only going as far as he necessarily needs to. But that is kind of a stretch. You might notice how fast the credits are going. I mean, even the credits, they don't seem that fast, but you can hear the music. This game has the longest credits I have ever seen in my life. I mean that quite literally. At normal speed, I actually timed it, and the credits lasted 29 minutes. I don't know all the stuff that they go through to make it last that long. I think it might have something to do with only putting a maximum of like 7 names on the screen at a time. But yeah, that's amazing. So anyway, I am pretty much done with Far Cry 3. I will be doing some bonus videos. I'm going to be showing the hunting. We didn't really do any hunting, but there are some special creatures that you do have to hunt in order to get the maximum possible upgrades for, you know, like the most quivers possible, the biggest wallet possible. You don't really need any of those upgrades in order to beat the game. We got through just fine and had plenty left over. But though that is something to show off, as well as all these special weapons. I didn't really show them off because it took long enough to show off all the regular weapons in the game, and to be honest, that is a lot of money needed in order to get all the special weapons. So I'll do a separate video showing the ones that I did not show, and there's only like 5, but still. So there's the ending, there's the weapons, there's the hunting. But that's for later. Thanks for watching, guys. I will see you in the next game.